गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर क्लास। टुडे वी विल डू चैप्टर सेकेंड ऑफ मेन कोर्स बुक। सो प्लीज टेक आउट योर बुक एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 16। चैप्टर सेकेंड, रामा इन एक्साइल। दिस इज एन एपिसोड बेस्ड ऑन द एंशियंट संस्कृत एपिक द रामायण। वन डे ए हर्मिट मीन्स ए पर्सन who lives alone away from society, brought the disturbing news of a crowd of people coming through the forest towards them. So a hermit came to them, to Rama and Lakshman, and he brought the disturbing news of crowd of people coming through the forest towards them. Lakshman climbed to the top of Jain tree. What happened? Lakshman climbed a Jain tree and saw a long procession of people winding towards them through the forest. In great excitement, he descended to the ground and cried. He came down to the ground and cried, "O Rama, beware. I have no doubt that it is Bharat who is coming here to finish his jealous mother's work." What Lakshman told to Rama? That it is Bharat who is coming here to finish his jealous mother. He wants to remove you out of his way forever so that he may rule Ayodhya. Gentle Rama rebuked his brother. Rebuked means scolded his brother, scolded Lakshman. "My dear Lakshman," he replied, "that cannot be. It cannot be. If Bharat comes here to all, he comes to do us good with some loving purpose in his heart." So what happened? When the procession drew near, when the procession came near, Prince Rama greeted Bharat with the tenderest affections, while Lakshman stood by suspicions and ready to protect his beloved brother. So Rama greeted Bharat and Lakshman was stood by suspicious. Bharat was weeping bitterly. Bharat was crying, flung himself before Rama's feet. Bharat was crying in front of Rama. "Dear brother," he said. "Dear brother," Bharat said, "on my return from visiting our uncle, I was shocked to find that my poor mother had forced our father to drive you into exile." What happened? "My mother has forced our father to drive you into exile and keep the throne vacant for me. But O Rama, dear brother Rama, out of grief for you, our father, alas, is dead. Our father is dead." Overcome with grief at learning about his father's death, Rama at first did not answer. But a moment later, he burst into tears. Rama was crying. He burst into tears and the two brothers embraced each other. Embraced means they hugged each other. "But brother Rama," continued Bharat. Bharat said, "Rama, I have come here to assure you that I will never take your place. I cannot take your place. Return, dear brother, to your rights and reign in fair Ayodhya." "Dear brothers, I cannot take your place. Please come back. Please return to Ayodhya and become king. I have promised for full 14 years to stay in exile." What Rama told? That "I have promised for full 14 years to stay in this forest. Shall I then break my oath and prove untrue unto my holy promise?" What do you mean that I should break my promise? "Brother, plead with me no more. I will not break my promise. I will not break my oath, nor leave this forest till the 14 years are past. I cannot go till the 14 years are completed. Please return to Ayodhya and rule in my place. You, Bharat, please go back and rule in my place. But this I promise you, I will not leave my years of exile in idleness. I will spend them so that they shall shower rich blessing on my people." In vain, Bharat pleaded. Rama stood firm in his purpose. Rama is firm in his purpose that he will not go back till 14 years are completed. Then Bharat bending to embrace his brother's feet, begged him of his sandals. What happened? Now Bharat is asking Rama to give his sandals so that he can take his sandals to Ayodhya. If you will not return, he cried. What Bharat is telling, if you will not return, I must rule in your place. Then I will never sit upon your throne. I will not sit on throne. Your sandals only shall occupy that royal seat beneath the white umbrella of the king. Bharat will rule only Rama's name. What Bharat is telling, I will not rule. I will not sit on that throne. Your sandals will sit on that throne, and Bharat will rule only in Rama's name. With unselfishness and love, the two brothers bade farewell, and Bharat returned to Ayodhya. Bharat came back to Ayodhya. There for 14 years, the sandals of Prince Rama, which he had brought from that exile, the sandals of Prince Rama occupied the throne beneath the white umbrella. All men paid homage to those sandals. Never was Bharat tempted once to be untrue to his elder brother. Dear students, what happened? But when the 14 years were up, 14 years were completed with Lakshman and sweet Sita by his side, Rama returned once more to fair Ayodhya. Rama came back to fair Ayodhya. There amidst the loud rejoicings of his people, all the peoples were very happy. He took at last his rightful place upon the golden throne beneath the white umbrella that served only for the king. So this was the story. Now see the meanings. Hermit, a recluse, means a person who lives alone away from society. Rebuked means scolded. Exile means enforced, removed from one's native country. Embraced means hugged. Oath means promise. Entreated means pleaded. Beneath means under. Rejoice, being happy or overjoyed. Use these words in sentence of your own. Now we will do exercise. So please take out page number 21. See, test your grammar. Let's add a little color to the class with some colorful and playful expressions and idioms. Match the idioms with their meaning. So first idiom is feeling blue. Meaning is feeling unwell, mainly associated with depressions or unhappiness. Second is gray area. The meaning is area where there is no right or wrong. Third is in the pink. Meaning is to be very good health. With flying color is someone who is expected to be a great success. Now, fun with vocabulary. Words that confuse. People get confused with the following pairs of words. Learn their meanings and use them in sentence to bring out their meanings clearly. First is altar. The meaning is a place to make an offering or to worship in a religious building. Sentence is always go to altar for inner peace. Second confusing word is alter, to change slightly. Sentence is we must alter our plan. Second is artist, one who practices a fine art. Sentence is Adhira is a good artist. Artisan, one who practices a handicraft. Sentence, the base made by the artisan is wonderful. Compliment, that which completes. The dark red balls complement the red leather chairs. Compliment and expressions of regards. I always get compliment for good work. For this farmer, meaning is peasant. Sentence, farmers always work hard for family and country. Former, first in position. The former president is planning a return to politics. Fifth is respectable, means worthy of respect. Sentence is, he came from a perfectly respectable middle class family. Respectful, one who shows respect. Sentence, he is respectful to his elders. Dear students, please revise this exercise. Dear students, your homework for holiday will be, you have to complete the literature reader chapter 1 and chapter 8 question answers in your note copy and you have to learn them. Dear students, please revise the exercise of both the books which we have completed in this month. Please do reading practice also. Thank you and have a nice day.